Hey guys, Josh here. When it comes to farming games, I feel like there's two main groups: farming games with combat and farming games without combat. I personally enjoy both, they offer quite a different experience, and just depending on my mood, I might want to play a game with combat, and sometimes I just want to play something a little bit more peaceful. In today's video, I would like to talk about 5 farming games which, in my opinion, have the most interesting combat. Some of these games actually focus a little bit more on combat than farming, and I think they're ideal if you're looking for a bit of action in your farming game. So let's get the obvious one out of the way and talk about the Rune Factory series. Rune Factory 4 Special, currently available for Nintendo Switch, also just came out on December 7th for PS4, Xbox, and PC, and also Rune Factory 5 will release worldwide for the Nintendo Switch in March of 2022. The series is moving to so many different platforms, and this will allow people who haven't played it yet to experience the franchise that introduced combat and RPG elements into farming games. All games on this list take inspiration in one way or another from Rune Factory, and you can't go wrong with that series, so I definitely would recommend to start there if that's not already done. In Rune Factory, you can choose from many different weapon types, such as one or two-handed swords, jewel blades, axes, gloves, staffs, and they're all fun to use and offer a slightly different experience. And also, when you use a specific weapon type, your character will level up in the skill associated with that weapon type and become more proficient. But also, you're not restricted to just one weapon type, so it's really easy to switch from one to another, and you will level up your skills pretty quickly. The combat is pretty simple for the most part. There are a few abilities to learn, but mostly you'll just press the same button, and you can also dodge. So it's very easy to pick up, however it does feel very fun and satisfying. Another thing I like about the Rune Factory series is the crafting system. I won't go into details as this could be a video by itself, but there are tons of different upgrades and effects you can apply to your equipment, and if you like grinding for materials and try to get the best equipment as possible, you will have fun doing that in Rune Factory. The farming mechanics are also a bit more complex than in Story of Seasons, and you'll have to take into account many different stats for your soul, such as its health, quality, growth rate, and more. So if you're looking for a farming game that goes a bit more in depth in everything that it does, with fun, action-packed combat, you really can't go wrong with a Rune Factory game. Also, most games in the series can keep you busy for hundreds of hours if you're trying to complete everything. So yeah, if you haven't played Rune Factory yet, just all of the games are really good, so give it a try. The second game on our list is a very unique one. Sakuna of Rice and Ruin, which is available for PS4, Switch, and PC, manages to perfectly combine rice farming with 2D side-scrolling action platforming. Let's start by talking about the farming, as it's quite different from all other games on this list. As the name of the game suggests, in Sakuna of Rice and Ruin, you'll have to plant rice. That's actually the only crop available in the game. So in spring, you'll till the soil and plant your rice, and as it grows, you'll have to remove weeds, bugs, and make sure that the water level is correctly maintained by taking into account things like the temperature. For example, during hot summer days, the water will evaporate more quickly, so you'll have to let more water in your field, and lots of little technical things like that. In autumn, also, you'll have to harvest the rice and then let it dry, and after that you'll have to thresh it and polish it, and you can make either brown or white rice. So if you decide to make brown rice, you're gonna get better stats from your food. So actually, in this game, you can cook some meals every day that are gonna give you buffs for that day. And if you make white rice, your daily buffs are gonna be a little bit lower. However, your permanent stats will increase more. So it's kind of a choice that you have to make if you wanna make either brown or white rice. And for better results, you'll want to fertilize your rice with different items found during your adventures. Not only is farming fun in this game because every step of the process is actually a kind of minigame, which makes it more interesting than just pressing the same button over and over again on each little square as you do in most farming games when you need to take care of your crops, but also you'll get better at it the more you play, and Sakuna as well. She will gain experience and unlock new skills and abilities, making things a bit easier for you. For example, at first it's a bit tricky to guess the right distance between the seeds that you plant, but after a little while, you will unlock a grid that will show you the ideal placement, so this is gonna make things a little bit easier for you. And depending on how well you took care of your rice and the specific stats of your rice, it will improve Sakuna's stats in combat. That's one thing I love about this game, is that the farming and combat are really well interconnected, so you'll have to fight a lot of different monsters and explore to make good fertilizers and get better rice, and then the better your rice is, the more your stats will increase, which in turn will make it easier to progress in the story and beat the different bosses. The combat is also a lot of fun, it's all in 2D, it's very fast-paced. You can do light or heavy attacks, you can do different combos, you can fight in mid-air, you can dodge. There's really a lot to do, you will also learn new abilities and be able to craft new weapons and armor that can give you special buffs. This game can get pretty challenging, especially during boss battles, but it feels so satisfying when you manage to beat them. For the most part, you'll have to learn their patterns and find some kind of strategy, as if you just bash randomly into them, you will die. But yeah, as I said, it is very satisfying, and also this game is just so beautiful. Even on the Switch, it runs so well, and the different seasons, different times of days always look so breathtaking, especially the sunset and sunrise. And I would really love to one day maybe see a Story of Seasons game with graphics like these. That would be the best thing ever. But for now, we have this game, and overall, Sakuna of Rice and Ruin is quite different than your typical farming game, but if you're looking for a lot of combat and a farming system that doesn't feel like anything else you've seen before, please give it a try and you won't regret it. The next game I think could qualify as the Dark Souls of farming games. Serenfate Fate is for those who are seeking some challenge, and I'm not saying this lightly. There is actually a warning on the Steam page, which I'm gonna be reading to you right now, so it says, "Danger ahead, please consider before diving into this world. Seren Fate is deceivingly difficult and you will die." Seren Fate is not a peaceful, relaxing collection game at its core. Reading text is crucial and tutorials are few and limited. A hefty grind is required to become stronger, and it is not developed by a team, I offer my best. I've played this game for about 8 hours now, still pretty early, and I have a lot to learn about it. I'm still confused about quite a few different mechanics, and I still have not managed to beat the first dungeon. In this game, you will die a lot, and you'll have to grind a lot too, so just keep that in mind. In Seren Fate, you get to pick from 3 different races, which are Seren, Val, and Human, and each comes with different perks and traits. Each time you level up, you'll get to attribute points to the different stats of your choice, so you can really build the character of your dream, or mess everything up. There is also a very complex skill tree, there's a lot in there, and skills are expensive, so you won't be able to get all of them. It's really the kind of game that you're gonna have to read, and you'll have to plan wisely which skills and which stats you want to boost, but if you do it right, it can be extremely rewarding. There are melee weapons and magic weapons in this game. For my character, I try to focus on magic as it allows me to fight monsters without getting too close to them. As I said, it is a very difficult game, however it doesn't really feel unfair, so you just have to be really careful and think about your actions and try to approach combat kind of carefully, because most enemies are really strong and they can kill you in one or two hits, so you just gotta be really careful, but the combat is pretty fun. And besides combat, there's also crafting, fishing, farming, befriending villagers, and pretty much everything you would expect in a farming game. There is also a spell system, which I find very innovative, and that's one thing I really like about this game. So throughout your playthrough, you will learn some spells, such as a spell for mining, woodcutting, or taming chimeras, which are basically pets that you can have in this game, and the game encourages you to catch all 50 of them. But going back to the spells, instead of just selecting the spell from a list or like just clicking on a button like in most games, each spell is a combination of different elements. I'll give you an example. So the first mining spell is Sun, Sun, Moon. So in your spell bar, you'll have to select the sun again, and then you click on the moon. Then you just select a rock that you would like to mine, and it will summon a magical pickaxe that will do the work for you. So there's plenty of different spells, and there's a spell book you can access to at any time if you forget your spell. But I just find this system so much fun, it feels rewarding when you're able to memorize the different spells. It's also so satisfying to see them in action, and I can't wait to discover all of the other spells available in this game. I'm having a lot of fun with Seren Fate, and I still need to play more in order to fully understand it. I would like to do a proper review of this game or even some tips and tricks videos, but there's just so much to learn and there is a steep learning curve. You will be confused at first, so if you're ready for that, go ahead and give Seren Fate a try. I would also recommend checking out the Discord for that game. I'll put the link in the description, as the developer and other players are pretty active on there and they might be able to help you and answer your questions. And the next game on our list is still in early access, but I've been playing it for close to 25 hours and I still have so much things to do. Sunhaven is set for full release on PC and Nintendo Switch sometime in 2022. You get to create your character by selecting one of the many races, such as Demon, Angel, Elf, and so many more. And it really offers a lot of freedom in terms of like creating your character and also decorating your house and things like that. So if you like customization and creativity, you will have a lot of fun with Sunhaven. But let's talk about the combat. So in Sunhaven, you can either fight with a sword or with a crossbow. The combat is pretty simple. There's just one type of attack. There's no combo or blocking mechanics or anything like that, so it's not very technical, but it's still fun. As you play and you level up your exploration, combat, fishing, farming, and mining skills, you'll get skill points that you can use to learn some new skills, spells, and abilities. Some of them are elemental spells that you can use in combat, such as a fireball, which is pretty powerful, and others can be used to facilitate your daily chores. For example, you can summon a cloud that will rain on your crops or an earthquake that will till the soil all around you. I found these ones really interesting, they make the farming a little bit easier and they will allow you to dedicate more time to explore what Sunhaven has to offer beside farming. There's a mine in this game and you'll need to go there if you want to get the ores needed to craft better equipment. There are also two other cities, Withergate and Nelvari, on top of Sunhaven, each with a completely different atmosphere, different shops, different quests and villagers. All of these cities look so good, and also that's the case for pretty much all the games on this list, but Sunhaven's put some emphasis on the storyline. The main questline will get you to travel to accomplish various tasks in all three cities, and the different characters will also regularly give you secondary quests, so you always have something to do. There's also some bulletin boards with different requests that are going to reset every day, so this game can definitely keep you busy for a while. And also, if you don't like doing all of these quests by yourself, you'll be happy to hear that up to 8 players can play together, which makes everything a lot more fun. I've had the chance to play in co-op a bit, and for the most part it was great, and we did not encounter much bugs, but keep in mind that since the game is still in early access, there could be some imperfections here and there for the multiplayer, as well as in other parts of the game, but I have to say that for an early access game, I really did not see that many bugs in Sunhaven. Also, some things are currently missing, such as seasons, festivals, and some of the quests. But there's still so much to do, so if you are interested and you cannot wait for the full release, I think it's definitely worth it, even as it is. So please give Sunhaven a try. And the last game on our list is available on all current consoles as well, and while it has certain flaws, I still enjoyed it quite a bit. So Kitaria Fables definitely leans more on the combat than on the farming. You'll get to plant crops and sell them, but there's not a huge variety. There's only one season and there's nothing technical about the farming. It's a very rudimentary system where you just water your crops and harvest them, and that's your best way of making money in this game. There's also no livestock, so you don't need to take care of any animals or anything like that. There's also not much in terms of social activities, no friendships, festivals, none of that, so just be aware of that before going into this game, as Kitaria Fables mostly focuses on its story and combat. Like in Sunhaven, you'll get to pick between a sword and crossbow, and you'll also be able to use some spells. One thing I liked about the combat in Kitaria Fables is that you can see when enemies will attack and where they will hit exactly. You'll have to use the dodge button a lot, and that's a big part of the gameplay. If you don't dodge, you will definitely die. The game can get pretty challenging near the end, and one thing to note is that it can be quite grindy. quests will require you to collect a high amount of a specific item, meaning you'll have to beat the same monsters over and over again, and you'll also need a lot of items if you want to improve your equipment, which is gonna be necessary in order to survive tougher monsters. However, once you finally manage to get that new equipment, it feels so rewarding as you're suddenly so much stronger, and it makes the grind worth it in my opinion. Another little thing with this game is that there's no experience or leveling system, so if you don't need items from a specific enemy, sometimes you'll find yourself just avoiding them because you won't be getting experience or anything from them. So all the character progression is done through equipment and spells, and to get the spells, just like for the equipment, you will need different items. So that being said, I really had a good time with this game. The characters and story are cute, I found the combat fun, and this game is really easy to pick up, and it also has a two-player co-op mode if you'd like to play it with a friend. So as I said, it has some flaws, but if you've played the other games on this list already and you're looking for something different, then I would recommend Kitaria Fables. Alright guys, so that's pretty much it for my favorite farming games with combat. Did I miss your favorite? Let me know in the comments. Also, I'm gonna be working on a list of the best peaceful farming games as well, so if you have any suggestions for that list, please let me know because there's a lot to pick from and I'm not too sure where to start, so let me know in the comments your thoughts. Please click like and subscribe if you'd like to see more content like this, and I'm gonna see you all in the next video.